Good morning, dear students of class 8. Welcome to this English online learning class. Today we are going to take up the lesson for the Bipin Chaudhary's Lapse of Memory from your book Honeydew chapter 4. And this lesson that we are going to continue is part 4 of the lesson. We have already taken up to part 3. So let us first quickly revise this lesson. What is memory? Memory is ability to remember things. And lapse means suddenly a person's memory gets affected and he stops recalling things, remembering things. So this is what has happened with Bipin Chaudhary. So there is a lot of suspense in this story, and the story is written by the famous writer Satyajit Ray. Now, every Monday, Bipin Chaudhary used to go to the bookstall, and this bookstall was Kali Charan in New Market. And he used to buy books, at least 5 at a time, because he loved reading. He was a very good reader, and he lived alone. He was not a good mixer. He did not have many friends, and he also did not like to spend time in useless talks, in idle chats. So, while he was at this Kali Charan's bookstall, he saw that someone was looking at him very minutely, very closely. And this person also talked to him. He started the conversation by saying that, "I think you have not recognized me." So, Bipin Babu said that, "I have not met you before." But the man was very surprised, and he said that almost every day for a whole week we were meeting. And he also tried to tell him that it was he who arranged for a car to the Hudro Falls, and says that it was in 1958 in Ranchi. And he says that, "My name is Parimal Ghosh." But Bipin Babu had a very good memory, but he could not recall this person. He thought that this man is making a mistake because he has never been to Ranchi. But the man started telling many details about his Ranchi trip. He said that, "You had a fall also in Hudro Falls. You cut your right knee, and because of which you were not able to go to Netrahar, although I had booked up the car. Then you did not stay in a hotel, you stayed in a bungalow, and there was a friend, Mr. Dinesh Mukherjee, who had also come with his sister. You had an argument about moon landing there." And then he also tried telling him about his family details, like he had no children, he had lost his wife 10 years ago, and his brother was no more, and he died insane because of some mental illness, and that is why you did not like going to the mental hospital. Now, Bipin Babu was very much puzzled because the man was telling so many details about his family correctly, but he had never been to Ranchi. Now, he could, in 1958, he was in Kanpur with his friend Haridas Bakshi. He could have confirmed from Haridas Bakshi by ringing him up, but Haridas was with his wife. He had gone to Japan some weeks ago, and he did not have his address. Now, he was not able to concentrate. He was badly puzzled. He was thinking what has happened to him. Now, he could have also contacted Dinesh Mukherjee, whom this Parimal Ghosh said that was with you. But he did not like contacting Dinesh Mukherjee because maybe Dinesh Mukherjee is going to make fun of him. So he was not able to concentrate that day properly because he felt very uncomfortable. But after dinner, when he started reading his book, he felt better. Then the other day he went to the office. But in the office also, he was very much disturbed. He was thinking, what has happened to him? Had he been to Ranchi? Has he forgotten? Or this man is making a mistake? But this man was telling so many details about his family. So he decided to call Dinesh Mukherjee. So he rang up Dinesh Mukherjee and he said that, do you know anything about the incident 1958? Can he recall any? So he said, what incident? Then Bipin Chaudhary said that, were you in Calcutta? Then he said, wait a minute, I will check up from my diary. And then he, Dinesh Mukherjee said that once I had gone in February to Krishnanagar to my nephew's wedding, but then he said that in the trip in Ranchi, I had been there, but you were also there with me. What has happened to you? Why are you asking this? Now, Bipin Babu was alarmed. He just put the receiver down and he said, thanks. And now he was really puzzled. What is happening to him? Is he forgetting things? Now, after lunch, he could not sit in his office anymore. And then he went home. Now, when he was in home, he was very much disturbed. And in the evening, his servant came and he said, Chunni Babu has come to meet you. Now, Chunni Babu was with him in school. And these days he was looking for a job. Bipin Babu did not want to meet him. But then, as he was about to tell his servant that you go and tell him that I will not be able to meet you and not for several weeks. But then as the servant stepped out of the house, of the room, Bipin Babu suddenly remembered that he can take the help of Chunni Babu to just inquire about his 1958 trip. There was no harm in asking him. So he hurriedly went down the stairs to the living room. Chunni Babu was there and Bipin Babu started talking to him. He said directly, I want to ask you something. You have a very good memory, but can you just tell me, did I go to Ranchi in 1958? Now Chunni said, 1958 or 59, I'm not very sure. But then Bipin Babu wanted to know from him whether he had been to Ranchi. Chunni looked very surprised. And he said, do you think you have any doubts? And then he said that you have been to Ranchi. It was I who arranged the tickets through a travel agency for you. And he started giving him all the details of the journey. He said, I only came to see you off at the station. And there in your compartment, the fans were not working, so I got an electrician to fix it up. Now, Bipin Babu was terribly alarmed. And Chunni Babu left. Now, it was high time that Bipin Babu should consult a physician. He consulted Paresh Chandra, a young physician, and told him about the symptoms. Now, the physician Paresh Chandra said that you have a horrible illness. Then he said, I would suggest you that you should take some tranquilizers and a nerve tonic. And also he suggested that you can also go to Ranchi. Maybe when you go there, you would be reminded of your previous trip. Bipin Babu liked this idea. So he felt better. After breakfast, he rang up his office and gave some instructions, and then he got a first class ticket to go to Ranchi. Now we'll continue with part 4. Getting off the train at Ranchi next morning, he realized at once he had never been there before. He came out of the station, took a taxi and drove around the town for a while. He realized that the streets, the buildings, the hotels, the bazaars, the Moradabadi Hill, with none of these had the slightest acquaintance. Would a trip to Hudro Falls help? He didn't believe so, but at the same time, he didn't wish to leave with the feeling that he hadn't tried enough. So he arranged for a car and left for Hudro in the afternoon. So he went to Ranchi. He did not find anything which would help him recognize that he had been to Ranchi earlier. So he decided to go to Hudro Falls. At 5 o'clock the same afternoon in Hudro, two Gujarati gentlemen from a group of picnickers discovered Bipin Babu lying unconscious beside a boulder. When he came round, the first thing Bipin Babu said was, "I'm finished, there's no hope left." So when Bipin Babu was lying unconscious, two gentlemen from Gujarat who were picnicking there, they found him, and they when Bipin Babu regained his consciousness, he said, "I am over. I am finished. I am no more." Next morning, Bipin Babu was back in Calcutta. He realized that there was truly no hope for him. Soon he would lose everything: his will to work, his confidence, his ability, his balance of mind. Was he going to end up in the asylum? So he feared that he's suffering from some mental problem, and would his fate be same like that of his brother? He's losing his control over his mind. Bipin Babu couldn't think anymore. Back home, he rang up Dr. Chandra and asked him to come over. Then after a shower, he got into the bed with an ice bag clamped on his head. Just then the servant brought him a letter which someone had left in the letterbox, a greenish envelope with his name in red ink on it. Above the name, it said urgent and confidential. In spite of his condition, Bipin had a feeling that he ought to go through the contents of the letter. He tore open the envelope and took out the letter. This was what he read. So there was a letter for him, and he decided to read that letter first. So this was written in this letter: "Dear Bipin, I had no idea that an affluence would bring about a kind of change in you that it has done." Affluence means you are rich, you are affluent, so there is a change in you. I never thought. Was it so difficult for you to help out an old friend down on his luck? I have no money, so my resources are limited. What I have is imagination, a part of which I use in retribution of your unfeeling behavior." So this was what his was written, that "I am not as powerful as you. I do not have money. Resources are limited. But I have one thing, and that is imagination. And this I thought I am going to use as a punishment because you were so unfeeling, you were so unsympathetic, unkind to me. Well, you will be all right again now. A novel I have written is being considered by a publisher. If he likes it enough, it will see through the next few days. But let me tell you, my novel is about to publish, and if the publisher gives an approval, in next few months it is going to be released." When Dr. Chandra came, and this letter was written by Chunnilal. When Dr. Chandra came, Bipin Babu said, "I am fine. It all came back as soon as I got off the train at Ranchi." So Bipin Babu said that, "I am perfectly all right. When I went to Ranchi, I could remember everything." So he's not telling the right thing to the doctor. "A unique case," said Dr. Chandra. "I shall certainly write about it in the medical journal." So Dr. Chandra was happy. He said that, "This is a very unique case, and I'm going to publish this in the medical journal." The reason why I sent for you, said Bipin Babu, is that I have a pain in the hip from a fall I had in Ranchi. If you could prescribe a pain.